like iPad or something like that, but with the twist competition. So we're trying to see, and we're also thinking about like giving away the game for Indian gamers here, if there is a way that actually we can do that. But everything that we would like to do, and then get in at least the gamers here to know about the game, aware about the game, if they can buy the game, they would go and buy it on Steam. But so this is we are. Okay. Thank you. Any questions? Yep.
Uploading it to Steam, it is okay for indie developers, but I have seen some of the bigger games like Prince of Persia and everything, they have their own fame.
Yeah.
So they can, everyone, like every kid knows about the Prince of Persia and everything. So yeah. They can directly go to their own site like Prince of Persia and download it from. Why we need to upload it to Steam when, obviously they have some, like, they can take their percentage. So why we need to upload to Steam if you have the fame or something like that? Like
why do you need to?
Yeah.
Why do you need to? I think that's a good feature. I think this just talks about like a Steamworks feature actually, about the what it does. The Steamworks is like they have around around 40 million users right now. I think they have around, I think at any time there are 20 million users. They online actually. So they built a very great social network. Imagine the Facebook for the gamers. Steam is all about. You can chat, and you can always, you can add a 0 hour update. It's like a zero, I mean it's like, you can update the game in the last minute, and then you have a patch. Patching system is so perfect, so great. And the gamers, they do, it's like, for example, the moment they miss it, you play the game, you start, your friends will know it actually, hey, you started playing the so-and-so twist game, so that comes up. So it's really built actually being viral. So the platform. Plus, at the same time, it's like there, all these gamers are there. There are actually, you have at any point in time 1 million plus or 10 million plus gamers who are online. So you all there. And then the way they put the store actually, it's pretty nice. The presentation is fantastic to discover actually. I mean, imagine how hard it is to discover actually an iOS app store and then an Android store. But in case of Steam, you don't have the problem. At least in the first 1 week, you know that actually what all the new titles came up. It's listed in a proper way. So they actually helpful in featuring actually if the game is good. And if you talk to them, if you get to know them a little bit more, and they feature the game in a big way. So I think for the big titles, it may not matter. I mean, for example, Star Wars franchise, anything for them, they wouldn't care about it. They wouldn't care about actually that 30% cut. Why should I give it to you? I mean, I take it. I put it, I have my own store, I sell it myself. Like the way Activision Blizzard, I mean, the Blizzard does that same thing, they don't. So it's a choice. You have a choice. If you think you can discover, I mean, for us, we need them. Oh, that is actually our own. They don't do that actually. They don't do on their own. So you ask them actually. It is actually a lot of times, it's the developers who go to them. Hey, I would like to give my game for 50%, 75% off, or I would like to keep it as a midweek promotion, free weekends. All these things actually, you have to first approve it. Or they would ask you, or you ask them.
And TF2 models?
Sorry?
TF2, Team Fortress 2 is there, right?
Yeah.
We tend to, sometimes if we buy this game, we're going to get these.
Oh, yeah. That again, actually, it's with the Valve is, that is, again, their choice. They choose. You pitch it to them. It's always the developer wants, actually, because the fall off from that, it's a great marketing tool for us. So we go to them, hey, I would like have a character which feels actually something I can use the TF2 items to do it. That's, again, it goes from our side. And then if they like it, that's again their choice. Then if they like that idea, and then if they think there is a synergy or there is something, then only they will pick it up. They will do it. So it's again, yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
We can take a small coffee break now, I guess, before we set up Rajat. So we've got coffee outside, guys. Thank you very much, Mani.
Yeah.
Give him a round of applause, please.
Thanks, sir.
I'm here to talk about basically games for gamers. Now, why I chose this topic, because there had been a lot of news recently in Business Line, Economic Times, and all that, that India cannot do console games, India cannot do hardcore games, deep games. We have cheap labor here, $40,000, we can do mobile game, let's just do it. Some big guys in the industry and all that, so. So the thing is that I don't accept that, you know, at all. The thing is we have done it in the past, we are doing, and we are doing because we believe in it. And Vinny, where is Vinny? Okay. So Vinny is, again, you know, he's trying to prove the same point here because he's making a game for gamers, you know, generally not for everyone sort of, you know, people. We don't have any problem with everyone playing the game, absolutely no, hell no. The thing is, but we actually relate ourselves more with the people who actually like to play games, they sit to play the game, talk about games. So yes, this is we, you know, we are TAX, it's reached the awesome game studio. So we are, okay, so we are not against casual game, which I need to, you know, probably, because it's just because I know the majority of the people will be from casual games or mobile game and things. We are also doing these games, you know, so these are casual games. So this is like, you know, this game we have already released 5-6 days back, yeah, and doing pretty good with it. It's free, so it has to do good. And the other game, the one over there, this is a mobile educational game which we were doing. We found the idea to be very good, so we just pushed it to a publisher. Publisher said that this game is more perfect for Nintendo 3DS. So let's just push for Nintendo 3DS first, and then we'll go back and release iOS version. So, and this game was ready, almost ready and ready to be launched. So right now we stopped, and we are pushing it to Nintendo 3DS now. People don't want us to move away from consoles, you know, even if it is handheld. So, but we still like our hardcore games. I just want to show what we have done. My team has done it before, and music is sound. Is there? Working on. It worked. This was again sort of hardcore on mobile. This is another game. So this is what we actually like to do, and this is what I'm trying to market, that, you know. So hardcore, the term hardcore itself has absolutely no meaning, you know. There is no way I can define hardcore, just like Mr. Potter, he had said, the Justice of Ohio, that there is no definition. I know when I see it. When I see Max Payne, I know it's for hardcore. When I see Angry Bird, I know it's casual. And so generally, like, you know, there are a lot of definitions, there are a lot of things what people generally talk about. That games what people actually start because they want to play. They sit there, start prepare, call their friends on a multiplayer thing, or and games with depth, a lot of complexities are there. Play them for hours on end, jab tak finish nahi.